just want to talk a little bit about this. This is in the springtime. We're in Chesterville, Maine right now. At one time, I will get to it in just a moment. One time, over on my right-hand side, there was, I suppose, a sawmill at one time. You can see the rocks that was brought in here. I would suspect there was a sawmill that expanded the rocks here. Of course, over the years they've fallen over. But I would suspect they'd probably be about 20 feet high on one side. And I would suspect that this was used for a sawmill. Wasn't many grist mills in this area, so I would say it was more like a sawmill. What they would do in the wintertime, they would bring the logs here. Of course, they'd bring them by horses and oxen and things like that, and they would pile them up around the mill. And then in the spring of the year, like now, they would divert the water into this channel. Sometimes they would have boards just holding back the water. And then, of course, when they would need the water, they would remove the boards. And, of course, through this narrow channel, oh, about 10 feet wide, of course, there'd be a lot of power to run the sawmill. Of course, I would suspect there'd be a paddle wheel in there. And that's how they would saw logs. And of course, they would probably saw like a son of a gun here, all right through the daylight hours. They'd go just, I don't want to say just as quick, but they'd realize that the water was not going to last. And of course, when the water was gone, that would be it. This is not a big running stream here either. So this is a runoff, and so when the runoff was gone, they would be done sawing for the year. They'd have to wait for the next year. I'm gonna go around to the other side. There's a pond here, and I would suspect that there would be a lot of water here. And I would suspect at night they would put boards in here. Of course, now it's all different, and they would hold back all this water, and then they would remove the boards, allowing the water to go under the road and then into the channel that you saw. But that's how a lot of sawmills in this area was done. They would do a lot of sawing when they could, because a lot of them didn't have the great big gasoline motors, because that cost money, of course, and all this water power was free. And that's what they would do. Free power, can't beat it. Yes, you work quite a bit. I bet they work 7 days a week here. I doubt they took a Sunday off, and I bet they worked out from sun up to sun down. And then, of course, you know, when it got dark, I bet they put the boards in, dammed up the water, held it back, tried to keep every bit of water that they could. But that's a little bit of history in this area. Like and subscribe. You never know what's going to be on our videos. God bless.